I get to talk about Matt. Matt Ruge and I began our careers with the Burnsville Police Department in April 2020. We were sworn in together and we became pals. Badge number 183 was pinned on Matt's chest, and I received badge 184, which made him my senior officer. And on occasion, he would sheepishly remind me of this. And then he'd needle me a little bit more by pointing out that I was very senior to him in age. He and I started at a unique time, which coincided with a pandemic and unrest. And Ruge rose up to these challenges, and he reaffirmed his commitment to service. His sense of humor and unwavering desire to make a difference immediately earned my respect. Matt and I worked together on our 11th shift in 2021, and we took as many calls for service as possible. He wanted to keep his day shift partner's plates clear while getting as many repetitions as he could. He earned the nickname Rogi because he would often go rogue by self-assigning calls outside of his designated area. He gained some significant experience early on due to his relentless work ethic and being involved in several critical incidents as well. In 2022, Matt sought a new challenge when he bid the night shift. He made dear friends. He learned from them, he backed them, trained with them, hung out with them, gamed with them. Ruge successfully handled difficult calls and developed tremendous confidence as an officer that year. His partners, sergeants, investigators found him to be extremely reliable and consistent. And Ruge earned another nickname, the Book. And that's because he went by the book in every situation. I rejoined Matt as his day-for-day dog watch partner in 2023. In addition, he and I became members of the department's crisis negotiation team, and we attended a 40-hour FBI course together in the fall. And he was a perfect fit for this role. And it was because of his calm demeanor and his authenticity. And my admiration and affection for Matt grew as we worked together and learned together. I think the entire department would attest that it was impossible not to love Ruge. He was smart, self-deprecating, quick-witted, humble. And last year, I watched Matt become a trustworthy resource for his partners, both old and new. This year, I chose a schedule that would allow me to work day for day with him again, and I was excited to hang out with him. I was excited to listen to our partners tease him about his dating life. I was excited to hear Ruge tell stories about the time that he spent with his family and friends during trips up to Champlin or out to Arizona or down to his old stopping grounds in Wabasha and Mankato. I also looked forward to responding to difficult calls with him, working as a team, deploying crisis negotiation techniques side by side, and we received that opportunity on Sunday morning, February 18th. And those touched by Matt in his passing must know, as Sergeant Medlicott mentioned, he was extraordinarily heroic that morning. He negotiated for several hours, which bought us time. And in law enforcement, we know that time is our friend. And the time that he delivered brought countless resources to the scene, which protected many of us. Furthermore, when the unthinkable happened, Matt brought his partner Paul to safety, although he was hurt himself. And Ruge repeatedly risked his life to save our friend, and in doing so, Matt made the ultimate sacrifice. And it is unacceptable that Matt did not go home that morning. The loss that his family and friends feel is unbearable. And at the same time, it is also true that Ruge left us with remarkable gifts. For example, I noticed that I'm saying I love you a lot this last week and a half, and I'm hearing I love you a lot too. And we're greeting each other with hugs. And I've noticed the outpouring of support for police officers and first responders in our families in a way that I've never seen before. And we're all in awe and so appreciative of the empathy and encouragement. I've also noticed that I'm praying a lot more with gratitude and for healing. And Matt also left us the gift of his example. Many of the things which I've already mentioned, his authenticity, his work ethic, his playfulness, his sense of humor, his selflessness, his trustworthiness, integrity, and commitment to service. And all these gifts that he's given us are good things. And we'd be better off if the things that we're doing now continue. And if they do, and we follow Matt's example, then we become better people for it. And if we become better people for it, then I think that makes Ruge an even bigger hero than he already is. So Matt, Ruge, Ruge, Rogi, the book, my senior officer, 45183, thank you for these gifts. Thank you for your friendship. Thank you for having our backs. We love you and we'll miss you so much.